This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses, 17 races to bring you in the wake of the Breeders' Cup. The big weekend down at Gulfstream Park West as they have Millions Preview Day. Up first, the Distaff.
And they're off. Sweet Khaleesi breaks well, so did Moment of Delight. Up on the outside, Our Girls, a Charmer, Silent Prayer in the mix as well. So it's a pressured pace early on. It's going to be Moment of Delight now to put ahead in front. Silent Prayer right to the outside in second. Our Girl's a Charmer. Going to be a bit wide in third. Sweet Khaleesi in the green cap moves in fourth. You Bought Her is in the fifth position at the rail. In sixth is R. Kinsley Doll. That one's followed by Winning for Sarah. And the trailer is Lucky Switch. So they move down the backstretch. Moment of Delight has the lead up by a length and a half. Our Girl's a Charmer right there now into the second spot as Silent Prayer has lost a bit of ground. Sweet Khaleesi is coming up inside of that runner into the third spot. You Bought Her is in a tough spot. In behind runners right now. Up on the outside, R. Kinsley Doll. Second to last, Winning for Sarah. The trailer continues to be Lucky Switch. Moment of Delight, the one to catch. Moment of Delight, still up by a length and a half. Our Girl's a Charmer is being asked the question. Not responding just yet. You Bought Her is now making up ground from third. And here comes You Bought Her in the orange silks. Sweet Khaleesi is dropping back. Lucky Switch and R. Kinsley Doll from the back. Moment of Delight has the lead. You Bought Her looks like the main rival. Here comes You Bought Her to the inside. A Moment of Delight. Moment of Delight with a half length lead, but here comes You Bought Her with every stride. Lucky Switch up on the outside, 16th to go. Moment of Delight finds more in the lead. You Bought Her one last try. Moment of Delight to win. You Bought Her finished second. Lucky Switch finished third. Winning for Sarah finished fourth. And Sweet Khaleesi in fifth. Then 1:22-2.
The two favorites right there in the exacta for you. Moment of Delight, officially the second choice at 3-2. Stanley Gold sends out the winner. Eddie Castro aboard makes every poll, wins by half a length, returns $5, even for the offspring of AP Warrior. The 6-5 favorite, You Bought Her, finishes second. Lucky Switch finishes third. Continuing on with the Saturday afternoon program, we go over to the turf, though, the Juvenile.
And they're off. Patchy Brave breaks well, so does Squadron. Up on the outside, here's Sunshine and Shadow. Front loaded, and here's Salute with Honor. Salute with Honor. Right along the hedge, out to the lead, up by a neck. Apache Brave wants to get up closer, and Apache Brave is going to make Salute with Honor go quickly into that first turn. Gap of Worry about three is Salute with Honor. Just took an awkward step on the lead. Apache Brave still in second, Squadron in third. Front loaded is in the fourth position, followed by Tipsy Kitten, who travels well in fifth. Mr. Papillon in behind that runner. Mugs-O-Matic, second to last on the trailer. Sunshine and Shadow is a very tough to control. Apache Brave has the lead. Apache Brave wants to go quickly, is up by two. Salute with Honor, trying to let that leader off just a bit. Squadron moving up from the third spot. Also moving up is Tipsy Kitten in front loaded from the fourth and fifth position. Mr. Papillon, Mugs-O-Matic still second to last in the trailer. Still Sunshine and Shadow as they've joined that pace setter. And here comes Salute with Honor to the inside and Squadron right to the outside. Apache Brave now dropping back into the third spot. Tipsy Kitten still outside of front loaded as they try to catch up with those leaders. Mr. Papillon in the green cap. Mugs-O-Matic, still the trailer, Sunshine and Shadow as they reach the top of the stretch. Salute with Honor and Squadron, and here comes Squadron right outside of Salute with Honor. Front loaded is running on. Tipsy Kitten's got to do better from there. Mr. Papillon, Mugs-O-Matic, late run. Squadron's now taking the lead. Salute with Honor, not done yet. Front loaded continues to make up some ground, but with a 16th to go, Squadron's now opening up. Squadron is up by about three, and it's all Squadron in the Juvenile turf. Front loaded ran on for second. Salute with Honor third, got close for fourth, Tipsy Kitten, and Mugs-O-Matic in 1:39-2.
Todd Pletcher hooks up with Eddie Castro. Second choice in the wagering, Squadron scores the comfortable 3-plus length victory, officially 3 1/4 lengths. This is an offspring of Midshipmen. They return $11.20. The 8-5 favorite, Front Loaded, can do no better than second. The pace setter, Salute with Honor, finishes third. Continuing on with the two-year-olds, but now in the sprint.
And they're off. Slow start for Red Crescent. Stormy My Way breaks out well, and Stormy My Way right out to the front. But here comes Two Steps Before. Now with a head in front, Cinderella El Chrome is hard sent at the rail as well as those two. Will now duel for that lead. Stormy My Way backed off of that pressure. Now sits in the third spot, about four lengths off those dueling leaders. Red Crescent, after the slow start, is moving up in the fourth spot. Red Cotton is in fifth. Then behind that is Sweet on the Ladies, followed by Thanks God, who trails the field. As they move to the far turn, Pace Duel on the front end. Cinderella El Chrome on the inside, Two Steps Before, right on the outside, Two Steps Before, maybe ahead in front. Storming My Way is watching that action from the third spot, moving up. Red Crescent trying to move up with that runner as well. Gap of another six. Back to Red Cotton, Sweet on the Ladies trying to run on. Quarter mile left to go. Two Steps Before and Cinderella El Chrome have now been swallowed up by Red Crescent and Stormy My Way. Red Crescent up on the outside of Stormy My Way. Here comes run from the outside of Sweet on the Ladies. And Sweet on the Ladies is making up a lot of ground and running right by the field. Red Crescent back to second. Stormy My Way running on. But it's going to be Sweet on the Ladies off the pace to win. Stormy My Way finished second. Red Crescent finished third. Red Cotton fourth. And Thanks God finished fifth and won 16-3.
Couple quick notes here. In the future, as we look at the chart in here, surprisingly, it did not list the objection or the inquiry into the stretch run. And I will say that there was nothing there, but you would think that in the chart in the Daily Racing Form, they would have it in there. But Sweet on the Ladies, who sat off of the 21.64. 44.08 pace, picks it up in the middle of the racetrack, wins by three, returns $8.20. Storming My Way, the 6-5 favorite, finishes second. Red Crescent finishes third. The Pace Setters finishes last and next to last. Back to the turf preview.
Dreaming of Gold, Restless. And they're off. Charlie Mops breaks well, so does Light the Night, Dreamy of Gold, Little Nick V. All with a little bit of speed, but it's going to be Charlie Mops on the inside to now take the lead. And Charlie Mops up by 3/4 of a length. Light the Night sits in second. Dreamy of Gold, the gray, is up on the outside of Little Nick V as they share third and fourth. Enterprising along the hedge in fifth. Outside of that is Uncle Vinny. Thinking Quality is going to be a little wide as Thinking Quality wants to move up closer to that pace. And the trailer is Sublime Appeal. Charlie Mops with the lead. Charlie Mops up by 3/4 of a length. Little Nick V tightly at the hedge in second as Dreamy of Gold has now come up into that second spot. Light the Night is in third. Still waiting for some room is Little Nick V, who's now back to fourth. Enterprising still in fifth. Outside of that runner is Thinking Quality, who's moved up. Sublime Appeal and the trailer is Uncle Vinny. So they move down the back stretch, slowing it down on the front end. Charlie Mops with the lead. Half-length lead on Dreamy of Gold, who's trying to apply some pressure. Little Nick V is, again, coming along the hedge now in the third spot. Light the Night in fourth. Enterprising, not asked for the move yet from fifth. Outside of that is Thinking Quality, Sublime Appeal, and the trailer is Uncle Vinny as they're into the far turn. Charlie Mops still the one to catch. Charlie Mops still up by a half-length. Dreamy of Gold in second. Little Nick V still waiting for room in the third spot. Enterprising is also going to look for a way through. Going to go out wide. Charlie Mops still the one to catch. Charlie Mops up by a half-length. Little Nick V, Dreamy of Gold. Sublime Appeal's got run along the hedge. Here comes Enterprising out wide. Enterprising out wide. Little Nick V also in there. Charlie Mops fighting back gamely. Little Nick V's now taking the lead, but here comes Enterprising up on the outside, and Enterprising's going to open up to win. Little Nick V back to second, Charlie Mobbs third, Sublime Appeal fourth, Dreamy of Gold finished fifth in 1:45.1.
Enterprising, Mike Baker, Tyler Gaffleone, the 3-2 favorite, wins by a length and a quarter, returning $5 even. Little Nick V finishes second, Charlie Mobbs finishes third. Now time for the two-year-old fillies to sprint.
Off the rainbows. And they're off. Our Angel Caitlin breaks well from the outside. So does Rachette. Here comes Wildcat Kate up the inside. Wildcat Kate going to apply some pressure. Rachette in between runners. Our Angel Caitlin is now those two go head and head. Up on the outside is Prove Me. Further outside is My Lulu, who's in the fifth spot. Also moving up is Lulu Laura. In behind that leading group is Surprise Wedding, followed by Lyrica and the trailer La Zaraya. Four furlongs left to go. Wildcat Kate has now taken the lead. Wildcat Kate is up by a length. Our Angel Caitlin re-engages right to the outside. My Lurler is also traveling up. Lulu Laura is tightly at the rail in the fourth spot. Two lengths back to Rachette, who's dropping back. Surprise Wedding running on with Lyrica. La Zaraya at the back as they approach the quarter mile mark. Wildcat Kate still with the lead. Wildcat Kate up by a neck. Our Angel Caitlin right there. Lulu Laura waiting for the cue from the rail. Wildcat Kate travels well, though, on the lead. Here comes Our Angel Caitlin up on the outside. My Lurler, Surprise Wedding, Rachette down the center of the racetrack. Lulu Laura trying to run on at the rail, but Wildcat Kate still has a lead. Our Angel Caitlin hasn't given in yet. 16th to go. Wildcat Kate, Our Angel Caitlin getting there up on the outside. Wildcat Kate trying to find more. Our Angel Caitlin got her on the line. Our Angel Caitlin first, Wildcat Kate second. Got close for third, looked like Rachette on the outside, and won 17-1.
Gerald Bennett sends out the winner, Paco Lopez, aboard Our Angel Caitlin. Scores the upset victory, returning $18.20. The offspring of High Cotton wins by half a length. The 3-2 favorite, Wildcat Kate, finishes second, and at nearly 25-1, Rachette finishes third. Continuing on with the two-year-old fillies, but now on the turf.
All in line, all set for the juvenile fillies turf. And they're off. Compelled breaks well. Southern Sis is asked for speed on the inside. Magalie is right there. And Hello Juliet is now Southern Sis. And Magalie will press on those two out to the front. Compelled takes back in the third spot. Outside of that, Hello Juliet. Bella Vincenza's in the fifth position. Bitacora is outside of that runner as those two leaders are speeding away. Towards the back, it's Silver Diva. That one is followed by Majestic Gale, and the trailer pops Irish Rose. A little bit of a duel up front as Magalie and Southern Sis have pressed on, and Magalie and Southern Sis have opened up. Got to be about 10 lengths clear. The third place runner, Compelled, travels with Hello Juliet. As those leaders quickly move down that backstretch. Compelled again has taken third, Hello Juliet in fourth. Bella Vincenza's in fifth, Silver Diva in behind that, Bitacora still at the back, Majestic Gale, and pops Irish Rose at Magalie, and Southern Sis have been at it head and head into the far turn. Still a big gap is Compelled. It's got to be about 12 lengths off of those leaders. Compelled is moving into it. Bella Vincenza, Bitacora's got some run, Silver Diva, Southern Sis, and Magalie with the lead with less than a quarter mile to go. But how much do they have left? Southern Sis has the lead. Magalie's dropping back. Here comes Compelled. Compelled is now running right after those leaders, and Compelled runs right by Southern Sis. Bella Vincenza's trying to run on. Also Majestic Gale, Silver Diva. But Compelled is now opening up, and this daughter of Warfront has just opened up on the field about six lengths in the finish. Compelled to win the juvenile fillies turf. Southern Sis finished second. Majestic Gale looked like she got third. Bella Vincenza fourth in 1:38-2.
Familiar Silks, Glen Hill Farm, Tom Proctor, Paco Lopez once again. She wins, Compelled certainly was. The offspring of Warfront wins by 6.5 lengths. I'll tell you, folks, on a firm turf course, you rarely see that type of winning margin, but the 7-5 favorite makes it look easy, returns $4.80. Southern Sis finishes second. Majestic Gal finishes third. And wrapping up the stakes action on Saturday afternoon at Gulfstream Park West, the Millions Classic Preview.
All in line, all set for the Millions Classic Preview. And they're off. Joshua's Comprise hopped in the air at the start. J.S. Bach has asked for speed from the outside, piloting on the inside. Mr. Jordan's going to take back a bit in the third spot. It's going to be J.S. Bach and piloting out to the front into the first turn. Mr. Jordan settles in third. Outside of that runner's Norman's Hero, High Riverside, three wide in the fifth spot. Moving up is Sarah Guaro in the Yellow Silks is in sixth, now tipping off the rail. Joshua's Comprise and Aces for John are the trailers as it's piloting. On the front end, piloting up by half a length. J.S. Bach right there in second. Mr. Jordan wants to get up with those leaders, but is held back in the third spot. Norman's Hero is two more lengths back in fourth. Sarah Guaro is progressing in fifth spot. High Riverside dropping behind Aces for John. And the trailer, Joshua's Comprise. Piloting, calling the shots, piloting. He's done it all the way so far. Still up by 3/4 of a length. J.S. Bach in second. Mr. Jordan still tracks those pace setters in third. Sarah Guaro is now moving up closer from the fourth spot. Norman's Hero is outside of that in fifth. High Riverside trying to run on. Aces for John. And the trailer is Joshua's Comprise. As they move into the far turn, piloting has the lead, J.S. Bach, and here comes Mr. Jordan three wide. Mr. Jordan's coming right after those leaders as they hit the quarter mile mark. Sarah Guaro's got some run in the fourth spot, is running on, but Mr. Jordan is traveling very well outside of J.S. Bach. Piloting is on the inside. Sarah Guaro is running on. Mr. Jordan now has the lead. Piloting is on the inside in second. J.S. Bach is in third. Outside Sarah Guaro, High Riverside late. But Mr. Jordan has a 16th to go, and Mr. Jordan is going to win the Millions Classic Preview. Mr. Jordan to win. Piloting finished second. Sarah Guaro finished third. High Riverside fourth. Then J.S. Bach finished fifth in 1:42.2.
Mr. Jordan, Paco Lopez, Eddie Plesa Jr., the 1-2 favorite, draws off to win by 3 3/4 lengths, returning $3 even. Piloting finishes second. Sarah Guerrero finishes third in the Classic Preview. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action for Woodbine and Churchill Downs.
Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
Of some of the top online wagering sites, Capital OTB won big in total player rewards, far surpassing some of the best-known wagering sites in America. While other rewards programs simply offer you points redeemable for gift cards, Capital OTB's rebates are paid to you in actual cash. Plus, Capital OTB gives you full and immediate access to your money. So if all you're getting now are points and gift cards, join Capital OTB Player Rewards today and get cash back. Visit CapitalOTBBet.com and sign up today.
This is unbelievable! Zenyatta! What a performance! One we'll never forget. Looked impossible, but it is Zenyatta, still unbeaten under Mike Smith.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to a pair of stakes races up at Woodbine. Up first, the Princess Elizabeth.
Away they race, bobbling the break a bit. Mythical Mission coming out in front is Evil Woman in the center. Away sharply deep on the track, Enstone making no bones about wanting that lead. Going forward is Ghostly Presence on the outside, a beautiful position early, Cinderella the center. And racing wider is China Rider. Over on the inside is Missy Chrissy as they turn from Spring Tempest, and then Lemon Zip on the inside of Crumbling Queen. And back on the rails, Erin Commodities bailed up a bit. On the outside is Mythical Mission. Enstone clears away in front. Enstone into the backstretch by 3 lengths to Ghostly Presence, and Evil Woman is third. A neck to China Rider. One to Cinderella now tucks it on the rail from Spring Tempest. A length again to Missy Chrissy and Crumbling Queen. A break of 2 or 3 lengths to Mythical Mission going past Lemon Zip. And last is Erin Commodity, and Enstone. Enstone has stretched that lead to a sizable 6 lengths. Enstone going along inside the 4.5 furlongs. Out by 5 or 6 to Ghostly Presence, Evil Woman, China Rider. A length away is Cinderella on the inside of Spring Tempest. Chiming in is Crumbling Queen, 3 wide. Mythical Mission picking up on the inside is Missy Chrissy looking for room. A couple away, Lemon Zip and Erin Commodity. Enstone has out in front a 4-length lead in second. Ghostly Presence, Evil Woman, third. China Rider under pressure, Crumbling Queen in the outside, looking for room, Cinderella. Mythical Mission coming on. And then Spring Tempest, Missy Chrissy, and well back Erin Commodity and Lemon Zip. Enstone in front. Turns only a length. Ghostly Presence in second. 3 lengths away, Mythical Mission trying to catch up the ground. Enstone trying to hang on, but Ghostly Presence is the biggest threat. Enstone from Ghostly Presence. Ghostly Presence and Enstone battle out the Princess Elizabeth. And Ghostly Presence has got up to win it. Ghostly Presence from Enstone. Mythical Mission third, then Spring Tempest or Missy Chrissy.
Big upset victory here. The offspring of Ghost Zapper sent out by Roger Atfield. Ghostly Present sits off the pace setter, who we'll get to in a moment. Runs him down, wins by 0.5 length, returns $41 even. Enstone, the 9-5 favorite, opened up on the back stretch, but got run down in the lane with Pat Husbands, and at 9-5 finishes second. Mythical Mission finishes third. Up next, the 113th running of the Coronation Futurity.
Off their race in the Coronation Futurity and looking for purse money, got out sharply with Escondera in the center. Away well, State of Honor, Guy Caballero. They've gone to the front. State of Honor on the inside with plenty of poise. A length to Guy Caballero. On the outside, Patchy Cruz. Tidal Dancer creeps up the rail and tracked along by King and his court on the inside of looking for purse money, and Woodbridge on the outside as they turn out the stretch. Escondera is second last and Girogin is last. Out in front, Patrick Husbands is controlling the race. State of Honor in front and doing it well. Leads by 2.5, Guy Caballero on the inside is Tidal Dancer. A length and a half away, fourth is King and his court on the inside of looking for purse money, and three wide, Patchy Cruz. A break of 2.5 to Woodbridge. Next to last, Escondera has settled in a relaxed manner, and a length away last is Girogin. State of Honor hasn't put a foot wrong, leads the way by a length and a half to Guy Caballero. Over on the rails, Tidal Dancer, Patchy Cruz a little closer now. On the inside is looking for purse money, nudging between horses, a length away, King and his court. Woodbridge is five off the lead, second last Escondera, and last is Girogin. They head inside the 3.5, and State of Honor by a length to Guy Caballero. On the outside, Patchy Cruz from Tidal Dancer. Wonder looking for purse money, pushed along a bit as the leader's gone for home a bit here. Guy Caballero is under pressure. Tidal Dancer goes to second, and the leader's really romping. State of Honor by a length. Tidal Dancer makes a run at the leader. King and his court the inside, and again looking for purse money, winding up. Woodbridge off the track. State of Honor and Tidal Dancer the top two down the lane. Guy Caballero in third. King and his court the inside. State of Honor in front. King and his court threading up on the rail. The Marcassi pair and King and his court reigning supreme again. King and his court bursting clear. Out what Escondera lay, but King and his court taking the Coronation Futurity. State of Honor second. The Marcassi pair 1-2, then Escondera. Behind them, Guy Caballero, Woodbridge, and a weakening Tidal Dancer.
King and his court. Marcassi, Gary Boulanger, the 5-2 favorite. The Austria Court Vision wins by 2.25 lengths over the Tapita. 2-year-olds going 1.08 miles. Do it in 150.76. You like that? $7.30 for the winner. State of Honor finishes second. Escondera finishes third. Over to Churchill Downs. On Saturday afternoon, they had 3-year-olds, the Commonwealth Turf.
They're in the gate, and they're off in the Commonwealth Turf to a good start. Sir Dudley Digs Down Inside was away okay. Squeezed back soon after the break was Surgical Strike as Hey Dakota came out. Meanwhile, up top, Scholar Athlete is up for the lead. Right to that one's outside is Icarin Road. Sir Dudley Digs is on a firm hold toward the inside. Tis a Runner races up to be fourth. Blackout also under a snug hold running along in fifth. One Mean Man is sixth. Zamperini, Bondurant are seventh and eighth and about 5 or 6 lengths off the lead. And then it's Hey Dakota running third to last. Surgical Strike second to last. And Discreetness is the last of them all. A lot of pace, though. 24 flat was the opening quarter, heading for the backstretch run. Scholar Athlete shows the way, leads by 3/4 of a length. Icarin Road in the outside prompts the pace from second, and so too does Tiz Runner in the clear, racing along in third. Sir Dudley Digs with a good spine in behind, saving ground around the first turn, covered up while fourth. One Mean Man is in the clear, racing fifth. Blackout is right in the thick of it while sixth. Zamperini is sneaking through toward the inside up into seventh and only 4 lengths behind. Bondurant's going to be wide onto the fire turn, 4 wide there. Hey Dakota still third to last, Discreetness and Surgical Strike. Onto the fire turn now. Scholar Athlete is still the leader, trying to get away from Icarin Road, who's keeping up so far. Just 3/4 of a length behind on the fire turn. Tizza Runner's under pressure. One Mean Man loops up on the far outside. Sir Dudley Digs is set to strike while in behind. Blackout is there too. Bondurant and Zamperini cuts the corner off the turn. Top of the stretch. Scholar Athlete is still the leader, trying to dig in for another furlong. Icarin Road is right alongside. One Mean Man's getting on track on the far outside. Bondurant is too. Hey Dakota, way down the center of the course, is kicking in with the gear. Two. Turdlugget Diggs is in behind down to the final 16th. Scholar Athlete way outside. Hey Dakota. Bondurant between them. Hey Dakota near the outside rail at 29-1 won it. Getting up over Bondurant. And then it was either Scholar Athlete, Sir Dudley Digs, or Zamperini.
Hey Dakota wins the photo finish in a huge upset here. 29-1. Denny Velasquez aboard. They win the photo, returning $60.20, eclipsing the former greatest winning mutual, which was in the first running, Broadway View, for Nick Zito, folks, returned $39.60. But the new high watermark, $60.20. Bondurant, the 3-1 favorite, finishes second. Scholar Athlete finishes third. Take a quick break. When we come back, Northern California and Southern California.
Come on.
I want sales reports on my desk by Monday.
Whoops. My bad.
Love racing? RTN brings you every live simulcast on your home television, plus live video streaming and race replays on your PC and mobile devices. To order, visit RTN.tv. RTN, a breed apart.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, OTB-TV is the Capital Region's choice for the most comprehensive and informative coverage of thoroughbred and harness racing. OTB-TV is the only area network delivering a steady viewership, reaching more than 540,000 households throughout the broadcast day and into the evening. Capital OTB's digital presence also plays a tremendous part in getting your message in front of potential customers. With more and more wagering moving to online, CapitalOTB.com can put your message in front of thousands of potential customers 24 hours a day. And with the addition of our new mobile app, new customers will see your message on all their digital devices. To see how affordably you can reach thousands of new customers, contact Capital OTB's Sales and Marketing Department today.
You're unbelievable.
It's in front, but here comes High Chaparral. High Chaparral, the defending champ, to take it to Bob Brown. These two arch rivals head to head with Joe Hart bearing down on them. It's going to be a three-horse photo finish to the turn. Here's the wire. Photo finish.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to Golden Gate Field's two-year-olds in the Golden Nugget.
And they're off. Right-hand man had an awkward beginning. Riser and Aqua Frio are the first two out. Right-hand man now recovers and moves into third. He's followed by Silver Assault, fourth, four lengths off the lead. And Uncle Grumpy is at the back. Riser makes a very easy lead to the half-mile pole and is doing it beautifully, in front by a length and a half. Right-hand man takes second. At the rail, it's Aqua Frio with Silver Assault fourth, three lengths off the pace. And Uncle Grumpy gets a nudge at the back of the pack. Catalino Martinez has Riser in charge three furlongs from home. He's a length and a half in front still of Right-hand man, who is now asked to get after him in second. Then it's Silver Assault third, racing on the outside of Aqua Frio. Those two only two lengths off the lead. Uncle Grumpy's at the back of the pack. Right-hand man right up alongside and goes right by Riser at the top of the stretch. Right-hand man very sharp at the eighth pole. Opens up to Silver Assault in a rematch, which is no match coming to the 16th pole. Right-hand man in a dominant performance under Juan Hernandez to score in the Golden Nugget. Silver Assault holds second. Aqua Frio third, and then Uncle Grumpy.
Right-hand man with Ron Hernandez in the saddle, the 6-5 favorite, the offspring of Street Boss, sent out by Jeff Bondi, wins by three, returns $4.60. Silver Assault finishes second. Aqua Frio finishes third. Friday afternoon was opening day down at Del Mar, christened the Bing Crosby Meet. And on Friday afternoon, on Veterans Day, they ran the Catherine Crosby.
And away they go. All came out smoothly. Kerry Bell along the inside, but now it's Do the Dance and Sobradora Inc. on the outside. Those three go off to lead them early. Then we come back to Amber Selly racing along in fourth, and Dressed to a T is the early trailer. Pastistan's first time round, and Do the Dance goes on to lead them, not in a big hurry. Kerry Bell tracks second at the rail. Sobradora Inc. is in third. Amber Selly content to sit back second last, no more than four lengths off the leaders, and Dressed to a T is still the trailer. They head to the three-quarter pole now and Do the Dance. Got this easy lead, takes them along just under two now. Sobradora Inc. is tracking from second, and Kerry Bell tucked in third. Then they followed by Dress to a T and Amboseli Trails, but no more than four lengths covers the lot. No change. They run to the half-mile pole and still Do the Dance shows the way by two lengths. On the far side is Sobradora Inc. Down at the rail, Kerry Bell traveling comfortably now goes up second. Dress to a T, the first one under pressure now, gets a tap on the shoulder to pick it up. Amboseli is still the trailer. 3/8 of a mile to go and Do the Dance continues to lead them. Now Dress to a T, got that wake-up call, and Dress to a T on the far side. Then it's Sobradora Inc. Kerry Bell needs room at the rail. Kerry Bell now down on the inside, and Amboseli. Five of them tightly bunched as they turn for home. Do the Dance, the leader. Kerry Bell now has room, and Kerry Bell comes after. Amboseli's finishing stoutly on the outside. Do the Dance holding on. Do the Dance, Kerry Bell, Amboseli. Do the Dance, the more they asked, the more she gave, and Do the Dance has won it. Do the Dance, 3/4 of a length to Kerry Bell, Amboseli, Dress to a T, and Sobradora Inc.
Do the Dance, the only horse north of 8-1, scores the victory, making every pole a winning one for Tyler Bays. They win by 3/4 of a length, returning a hefty $28 even. Kerry Bell finishes second as the 6-5 favorite. Amboseli finishes third. On Saturday afternoon, named after one of my favorite movies of all time, Let It Ride.
And away they go. All came out well. The gray little Scotty is quick, but so is Curlin' Rules. Curlin' Rules now takes the advantage. Camino del Paraiso right there at the rail. Defiantly drops into the four spot, being followed by Mittersill and Baranpour as last. Six lengths would cover the lot. Into the first turn they go, and Curlin' Rules all alone out here. No one putting any pressure on him. Curlin' Rules goes on to lead just under two. Along the inside, Camino del Paraiso, and now there goes little Scotty up into second. Then there's a gap of three lengths back to Defiantly in the fourth position. Alongside of that comes Mittersill and Baranpour last, but no more than 3.5 covers the lot. Now even taking closer order now, past the 5/8, and Curlin' Rules the leader to little Scotty, but Baranpour has gone from last all the way up to third now as they run to the half mile. Camino del Paraiso in the white. Mittersill is comfortable in fifth, just 2.5 off the leaders. Defiantly dropped back last, but no more than 4.5 off them. They bunch past the 3/8 pole now, and Curlin' Rules comes under pressure. Little Scotty right up alongside. Baranpour's on the far side, and Camino del Paraiso going well. Camino del Paraiso needs room at the rail. Mittersill is starting a run too. Mittersill coming powerfully. Homeward bound, wide open, little Scotty, but here's Mittersill with a big run down the center of the track, and Mittersill has gone on to get the lead. Rake run from Defiantly. Defiantly coming fast. Mittersill hanging on. Defiantly, Camino del Paraiso late. Defiantly to get up. Defiantly got up to win it to Mittersill. A flying Camino del Paraiso, and then Curlin' Rules.
Defiantly, Craig DeLossi, Gary Stevens, the only horse above 8-1, longest shot on the board. From last to first, they win the photo finish, returning $29.60. Mittersill finishes second as the 2-1 at 2-1. Cameo Perry Acio finishes third. The 8-5 favorite, Curlin' Rules, well, not on Saturday, finishes fourth. Sunday afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, in amongst all of the football action, we had a 1-9 shot in the Betty Grable Stakes.
And away they go. Cuddle Alert was off a little awkwardly. Quick into stride here is Chow Chom in the gold colours, now being joined by Nola Gray, the grey at the rail, being followed by Harlington's Rose in third. Behind that, Cuddle Alert now pulled away up just two lengths off the leaders. My Fiona second last. Barbara Beatrice trails 5 off the leaders. They head past the 5/8 pole, and Enola Gray along the inside and Chow Chom. They stride for stride. Harlington's Rose is in third. Cuddle Alert on the inside of her. They've been followed by Barbara Beatrice, the grey, 4 lengths off the leaders, and that'll leave My Fiona at the back. Into the turn they go, Enola Gray at the rail, and Chow Chom stride for stride. In behind that comes Cuddle Alert, Harlington's Rose. Barbara Beatrice now has to go after them on the far side, and then My Fiona. Coming to the quarter pole now, Enola Gray still the leader. Chow Chom tries to hang tough on the far side. Barbara Beatrice in the white blinkers coming on third, and then Cuddle Alert. Top of the lane now, and Enola Gray's Get the Rain shaking at her. She goes on, but Chow Chom's running a huge one. And Chow Chom and Enola Gray stride for stride through the lane. Chow Chom and Kent DeSormo now take the lead with 100 to go. And Chow Chom's going to upset the favourite Enola Gray. Chow Chom and Kent DeSormo take it a length and a half to Enola Gray. Then Cuddle Alert, Barbara Beatrice, Harlington's Rose, and My Fiona.
Kent DeSormo, though, on the outside, the only other horse in single digits, scores the length and three-quarter victory. A huge upset, returns $19.80. Enola Gray, to me, never looked like a winner. I thought she was fortuitous. I didn't think she was going to run second at one point in the race. But Enola Gray, the 1-10 shot, does run second. Cuddle Alert finishes third. I take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to come back east for the Big A.
Pick, bet, and cheer on world-class horse racing from Woodbine and Mohawk racetracks. Over 130 live thoroughbred days, over 200 live harness days, loads of action, tons of bet types. The guaranteed pick four, jackpot high five, and pick six bets are just the beginning. Join the ranks of Woodbine and Mohawk players from all over the globe and make your bets count. For more information on the latest updates on events and offers, visit woodbineentertainment.com.
Not at the track and not near a computer? No problem. Wager with Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System and you'll never get shut out again. Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System is quick, simple to use, and guarantees your wagers are accurate and placed on time. For more information, visit CapitalOTB.com or call Capital OTB's customer service hotline at 800-292-BETS. Capital OTB's Touchstone Wagering System. Never get shut out again.
I got it. Watch me. I got it. Hey! I got something that makes me want to shout. I got something that tells me what it's all about. I got a move that tells me what to do. If you don't, brothers and sisters, then you won't know what it's all about.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turn our attention to the Big A, a pair of stakes races on Saturday afternoon. Up first, annually the end of graded stakes turf action in New York, dropped down $50,000. So it's the $200,000 Grade 3 Red Smith.
And they're off. I'll Call is going out for the early lead. Smooth Daddy moves up into second with Rum Tum Tugger. And on the outside is Tale of Fancy. They move around the far turn for the first time. I'll Call is the leader over Smooth Daddy. Then Rum Tum Tugger and Tale of Fancy heads apart third and fourth. Bigger Picture is on the outside of Artie's Silver Mine. Then comes Messi, who's racing in seventh. Wake Forest to his outside in eighth. Up with the Birds is ninth. Danish Dynaformer is 10th. And Biz the Nurse is the trailer in 11th. The opening quarter mile was run in 25 seconds. I'll Call has the lead here over Smooth Daddy, with Rum Tum Tugger tugged in down at the rail in third. Tale of Fancy on the outside runs in fourth as the field heads for the clubhouse turn. And it's I'll Call with the lead. Smooth Daddy remains in second, and Rum Tum Tugger is third. Tale of Fancy races in fourth. Then it's Artie's Silver Mine next in fifth. Bigger Picture is sixth. Messi is seventh by a head. On the outside is Wake Forest in eighth. Then it's Danish Dynaformer, followed by Up with the Birds, and Biz the Nurse is 11th. The half in 49 and four, three quarters in 115. I'll Call continues to lead here. It's I'll Call by a half length with Smooth Daddy on the outside. Now moving on through his bigger picture to take third. Rum Tum Tugger dropping back. On the outside, Taylor Fancy is on the move. Messi and Wake Forest move as a team. And now Danish Dynaformer is gaining ground on the extreme outside. That move is followed by Up With The Birds. The field is at the top of the stretch in the Red Smith handicap. And it's I'll Call the one to catch. Here's bigger picture. Here's Danish Dynaformer on the outside. And Wake Forest is there. And then Up With The Birds, Danish Dynaformer, and Big Picture. And running third is Wake Forest. They come for the wire. It's Bigger Picture, and Jose Ortiz makes it three wins in a row on this Saturday at the Big A. It was close for a second between Wake Forest and Danish Dynaformer.
And I think for the first time this century, folks, on back-to-back years, we ran the Red Smith over a firm turf course. And score one for the big good guys. Bigger Picture, ladies and gentlemen, comes from off the pace. Jose Ortiz in the saddle, the offspring of Badge of Silver, wins by a length and a quarter, returns $21.40. Danish Dynaformer looked like had a chance to win this race from well off the pace, finishes second. And the 3-4 favorite, Wake Forest, finishes third. Also on Saturday afternoon, three-year-olds, a mile and eighth on the dirt in the Discovery.
And they're off. Styx Stately Dude, Wild About Deb, Neolithic moves up in between horses, Adulator at the rail, Sunny Ridge on the far outside, and Gift Box is up close as they race into the clubhouse turn. Styx Stately Dude has come away with the lead. Neolithic, Adulator right together, second and third. Wild About Deb on the outside is fourth. And then it's Gift Box next in fifth, followed by Sunny Ridge in sixth. Governor Malibu races in seventh. Vulcan's Forge is eighth. And My Man Sam trails the field in ninth after an opening quarter mile in 24 1/5 seconds. They move up the backstretch. Styx Stately Dude leads by 3/4 of a length. Neolithic on the outside is in second. Down at the rail is Adulator, Wild About Deb alongside. Their heads apart third and fourth with Gift Box in fifth, 3.5 from the front. Now Governor Malibu advances down at the rail from sixth. Sunny Ridge runs in seventh. On the outside is Vulcan's Forge. My Man Sam continues to trail. The half was run in 49 1/5 seconds, and now there's less than a half mile to the wire. Styx Stately Dude maintaining a narrow lead over Neolithic. Styx Stately Dude by a neck. Neolithic on the outside in second. And then it's Adulator, Wild About Deb. Gift Box is on the extreme outside. Then it's Sunny Ridge, who's racing in sixth. Governor Malibu is down at the rail. 3/4 1/13 4, and they're at the top of the stretch. It's Neolithic and Styx Stately Dude. Adulator looks to come through down at the rail. Gift Box is fourth. My Man Sam has moved up to fifth, but now they're coming down for the 16th pole. It's Styx Stately Dude and Neolithic. It's between those two. It's going to be Styx Stately Dude to win the Discovery. Neolithic was second. A photo for third between My Man Sam and Adulator.
Styx Stately Dude goes to the front under Joel Rosario for Kieran McLaughlin. They score the victory by a length and a quarter. The winner returns $14.40 at 22-1. Neolithic finishes second. My Man Sam finishes third. The 8-5 favorite, Gift Box, can do no better than fifth. On Sunday afternoon, the Staten Island division of the Stallion Series.
And they're off. It's Rosie P who goes out for the lead, and Perfect Freud came away racing in second. From the outside, Frosty Margarita next in third. Then it's a three-length break back to Highway Star in fourth. Storied Lady is fifth. The favorite, Super Surprise, down on the inside in sixth. Family of Roses runs in seventh, and it's Lady Creesa and Wonderment as they head up the backstretch. Big long shot. Rosie P is the leader, right behind Frosty Margarita and Perfect Freud through a quarter in 22 2/5 seconds. Highway Star is racing in fourth. Almost four lengths back to Super Surprise, who's down on the inside in fifth. Super Surprise about eight lengths from the front. Then comes Storied Lady. Family of Roses, the gray on the outside, Lady Creesa, and Wonderment. half mile, 45 2/5 seconds as they come for the head of the stretch. Rosie P has given way, and it's Frosty Margarita on top. Frosty Margarita has a three-length lead. Highway Star in second. For the back, it's Super Surprise. And on the outside, Family of Roses. Frosty Margarita trying to hold off Highway Star. Frosty Margarita, Highway Star. Super Surprise is third. It's Highway Star who has the lead as they come for the finish. Highway Star wins it. Look like Frosty Margarita held second over the odds-on favorite, Super Surprise.
Highway Star, Angel Royal in the saddle, makes it look easy for the offspring of Girolamo. They win by 3 1/4 as the second choice in the wagering, returning $9.20. Frosty Margarita finishes second, and the 4-5 favorite, Super Surprise, finishes third in the Staten Island. That wraps up this week's edition of HNC. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your stakes action from around the country, and join us next time for Horses and Courses.
Watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off Track Betting.